ever get that dizzy, nauseous feeling when you spin in circles, ride a roller coaster, or read while riding in a car? What's the deal? Why do we get dizzy? Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
It turns out that dizzy, nauseous feeling you get actually has less to do with your belly and a lot more to do with your ears. It's true. You see, your ears are actually the most important part of helping you keep your balance. Deep inside your ears, past the earwax and past the eardrums, sits three special organs called the vestibular system. The thin, loopy-looking, fluid-filled organs in your ear respond to every movement your head makes. As the fluid moves around, it bends little hairs that send signals to your brain. This lets your brain know where your head is moving. Instantaneously, the brain relays that info to your eyes so they can brace for whatever movement you make and keep your vision from shaking like a camera. The vestibular system might be the most important part, but it's not just your ears that keep you balanced. Your eyes also help sense where you're moving and in what direction. Your skin also helps us understand which parts of our body are touching the ground, if any. And your brain helps relay messages between all the different parts of your body in a split second so that we don't even notice. Okay, so that's how our ears, brain, and body work together to help us move around, but what about dizziness? What actually causes our balance organs to get thrown off enough that the world seems warped? Well, that has to do with all that fluid inside the vestibular system. You see, whenever we spin around super fast, the fluid inside our ears moves around really fast too, trying to keep us balanced. But when you suddenly stop spinning, the fluid in your balance organs keeps on moving, sending signals to your brain as if you're still in motion. This clashes with other signals from the rest of your body that are telling your brain that you've stopped moving. That's why it's so hard to find your balance when you get dizzy. Your brain is getting mixed signals and doesn't quite know which way is up. Literally. Of course, plenty of people get dizzy from things other than spinning around in a circle. Motion sickness can be caused by much simpler movement, like flying in a plane, riding on a boat, or reading in a car. In those cases, your brain is still getting mismatched signals. When boats bob around in the water, you can't see the movements, only feel them. Or when you're reading in the back seat, the book's movement doesn't match the car's. On a plane, you might feel all kinds of turbulence, but you can't see it. All of these different disconnects can cause mixed signals in your brain, which makes you feel dizzy and sick. Sometimes so sick you can even throw up. So, moral of the story? Spin with caution. Otherwise, you'll be putting the sick in motion sickness. Yuck!